Hello students, welcome to your computer classroom. So in the previous class we have completed our chapter 5, the exercises. We have seen about the basic nature of HTML pages, the different versions of HTML, the editors. We have seen that the program where we will write the HTML code. Now in this chapter, which is chapter 6, we will see more about HTML. In this the different topics which we will cover are: what is HTML, how we can create the HTML web page, how to save them, clear, the few of the basic HTML tags we will see. Then after writing this HTML program in any editor, how we will display that document in the web browser, clear. Then how we can write, how we can format these HTML pages. So this is all about the web page designing. So let us start our this new chapter. So already we have seen that what is HTML. So HTML is a hypertext markup language and is a computer language which is used to create web pages. So this we already know that using these HTML we can create our web pages, and this is a, you can say, a language as well, the computer language using which we can design the web page. Now in this chapter we will see that what is the basic HTML document look like, how we can include the tags, clear. Now let us see what is the basic structure of HTML document, clear. So first is understanding HTML document structure. So every web page has certain HTML tags that gives them the basic structure, clear. So earlier also we have seen that in the HTML pages we have some tags which are written in this angular bracket, clear. So these are the tags. In this we will see there are different various types of tags, and when we will understand these tags, it will be more easy to use them, and whatever the document we are creating according to the need, means if there is a need of table to be inserted, if there is any image which we want to insert in the web page, so using these tags we can include them in our web pages. So first is HTML tags. So as we are talking about that HTML tags are, these are written with the angular bracket. So first is HTML. Basically this tag will denote that this, the code which you have written, that is a HTML code or HTML page is going to be designed using them, clear. So HTML is the basic HTML tags which appear at the beginning and end of the HTML document. So whenever we are creating any web page written which is in HTML code, so first beginning will be the HTML tag, and at the last it will also end with HTML tag. Only difference is at the closing of the document it will be a forward slash along with this HTML, clear. So this denotes the closing tag. When we have this forward slash along with this, so it denotes the closing tag, clear. So here also it is the same, the HTML and back forward slash HTML, these are the basic tags which we will write in the HTML code which we are writing. So when a browser comes across these tags, it knows that everything within the two tags define a web page, clear. So whenever we will write any HTML program, HTML code, all of this is going to be represented in any web page. So at the beginning and at the end of the document, when these tags are written, which tags? HTML and closing HTML. So the browser will interpret this by using these tags it will understand that the whole program is about a web page. Clear? Now next is different other types of tags. So first is header tag. So the document header tag. So there is a after the HTML tag we have the heading tag, that is head and forward slash head. So this is opening tag and this is the closing tag. What is the use of this? So we can use the header of HTML document to add expressive information to your web page. Clear? So using these head tag, whatever the you can say the information about the web page, this can be given using these heading tag, that is the head tag. And when we will use these heading tag, this heading tag will be used just after the HTML tag. Clear? So first will be the HTML tag, next will be the heading tag. Now after the heading tag we have the title tag. Clear? So this title is basically whatever the document which we are creating, we will give a title of that and it will appear at the top of the you can say the page, which is in the different tabs. When you open the browser, we have different tabs. So whatever the title we are giving, the same will appear on the tab of the browser. Clear? Let us read this as well. So you can add a title to your HTML document to help people search your web page. The web browser displays the title in the browser's window title bar. Clear? So the title bar here means the tab. Nowadays the browsers are, you can open multiple windows in a single browser, so which is appearing in different tabs. So whatever the title we are writing, the name will appear in the tab name, that is the title bar. And what is the tag for this? The title and this closing title with the forward slash. So the title tags define a page title and appear inside the document header. So first we will write HTML tag, then the second is header tag, and in the header tag we will write the title tag. Let us see example of this. So if I come to here, you can see the basic nature of this. So HTML tag is the beginning tag which is written at the first, then the heading tag. There are, we have some more information. Now in the heading tag, as we are talking about that, we will write the title tag. So title is written in between the heading tag. Clear? Here you can see that heading, let me take the color. Clear? So this is the heading, you can see, which is written inside the HTML, and the title tag is written in the heading tag. So first we will write HTML tag, then after the HTML tag we will write the heading tag. After HTML we have heading, so we have the head tag. These are the tags and the name should be the same, and in the heading tag we have the title. Clear? So these are the opening tags without the slash symbol. Then when we have written whatever the document, whatever the text you have to write in the title, then we will close the title. Clear? So the same you can see here, that here we are starting the title tag and here we have closed the title tag with the forward slash. And earlier we have started the heading tag, then after writing this title we have closed the heading tag. Clear? So this is the beginning of the HTML document. First we will write heading tag, then the head tag, and after that we have the title tag. Let us come to the book. Clear? So this was, the first was HTML tag, and after that we have seen the header tag, and next is the title tag. Okay, next is body tag. Let us erase this. Come to the next, that is body tag. So this body tag let us read this. The noticeable content that makes up your web page, including paragraphs, lists, tables and images, lives in the body of your HTML document. Clear? So earlier this, what we have written, the HTML tag, head tag and title tag, that was the beginning of the page. Now whatever the element, whatever the text, image or table which you want to get represented on your web page, that all is written inside this body tag. Clear? So here also you can see that what all we can include in this body tag, the paragraph means the text in the form of paragraph, then list, tables, images. Clear? So the main part of this web page, that is the whole content of your web page, that all is written inside the body tag. Clear? And what is the tag of this? The tag for body tag is this, in the brackets we are writing body and the closing is the forward slash body tag. So this body tag comes after the heading tag. Clear? So starting was the HTML tag, then in the heading tag we have written the title. Clear? So this title was inside the heading tag, and when we have closed this heading tag after the title, then we will begin the body tag. Clear? The same which we have seen in that also. So here you can see as well that after closing the head tag, we have started the body tag here. Clear? So HTML tag was the beginning. Let us erase all this. HTML tag was the beginning, then heading tag. Clear? After the heading tag, we have started the body tag. So whatever the text, image or paragraph which you want to write, this the main content will be written in the body tag. Clear? And after ending this body tag, again we will close the HTML tag. Clear? So this is the tag of the body tag, and these are the different contents which can be included using the body tag. Okay, let us erase all this. Coming to the next, that is how we can create and save a web page. Clear? So in the previous chapter also we have seen, for creating any web page we need a editor. So this editor can be of different types. If it is normal HTML document, so we can use any text editor like Notepad. Clear? Then we have HTML editors, we have WYSIWYG editors which we have seen in the previous chapter. So we will see a normal text editor, that is the Notepad. Okay, so you can use a text editor to create a web page. Start the text editor to create a web page. In this chapter we will start with Notepad, that is the text editor. Clear? So as we have seen that the normal text editor is the Notepad, which is present in all of the operating system. So we don't need to install any other software. Only Notepad is sufficient to write the HTML code. So first, how to start the Notepad? Already you know, if it is the Windows 7 or earlier versions of the operating system, then we will go to the start all program. In there we have the accessories and you can write Notepad. Or directly if you are using the latest operating systems, there only you can search, press the window key, write the Notepad. Here it will appear, and click on the open button and it will open. Clear? So this way the Notepad can be opened. Now how to write this? So basically for writing this, whatever the, so here a normal text has been written, a paragraph is written. So let us read this as well. So when you type text in the Notepad, the text may scroll off the screen. Clear? So whatever the text which you are writing, it may happen that the text goes beyond this the window which is appearing. Clear? So we will need to scroll the page. So if you want not to use the scroll, then you can use another feature, that is the wrap text. So here it is the same. So if the text scroll off the screen, but the text will fit properly on the screen when you view the document in the web browser. You can choose to wrap text in the notepad. To wrap text in the notepad, perform these steps. Click on the format menu and click on the word wrap if it is not already selected. Clear? So let us come to the notepad. Here I have taken. So a normal paragraph we have written. So here you can see the text is scrolling and it is more than the window size. So if you want to use the wrap text feature, here you have the format button. Here you can use the word wrap. Clear? So this way the text will be wrapped in the same window so that we can view all of the text on the same page. Clear? So whatever the text we write, basically this can be written. So here we are not using any tag right now. We are simply writing any document in the notepad. Whatever the text you want to write, this is a paragraph or a single sentence also can be written. Now let us see how to change this text written in a HTML form. So if we come to the book once again, let me close this. So here if we want to this written paragraph to be converted into the web page format or HTML format, let us see what we are going to do. So here we have opened the notepad and we have written this whatever any paragraph in this notepad window. So if we want to view this in HTML format, we are going to save this. So go to the file tab. When you close click on the file, we have the save and save as option. So you can choose either of these. So when you click on the save as or save, save as dialog box will open. So when this window will open, what we have to write? We have to write the name of the file. And here we can notice that the extension of the file is required to be written .html or .htm. Clear? So whatever the name of the file you want to write, that can be chosen. The only thing which is required for converting this into HTML is we need to write the extension of the file in the format of .html or .htm. Okay, so let us follow the same steps. So if I come to the notepad window, here we have written our text. Now click on the file, click on save or save as. So when you click on this, here you can choose the destination also, whatever the folder or subfolder you want to choose. This can be chosen from here. Already you are familiar about this. So suppose this is the file name. You can choose, suppose I am writing HTML. Okay, so the same will be extension of this. Let us write some other name. For example, new. Clear? So suppose I am writing the name of the file as new. Then what is the extension of this file? The extension of this file will be written .html or .htm. So here .htm I am writing, or .html, anything. Both of this is correct. Clear? And we don't need to change this in this type. Save as type is already the .txt. Clear? Then click on the save button. So here this file is now saved with name new. with extension .html. If I come again to the book, here you can see the same steps. So whatever the name which was written here, it was written index and extension is htm. Then here, as we are talking about, we can navigate the folders or the different destination where you want to save this file. Then in the save as type, what we have to choose the different here we have the different formats. So already the text document, that is the .txt, was the save as type which we need to choose. So that was already selected, so it was .txt. Clear? Then when you click on this save button, this file will be saved with .html extension. Clear? Now let us read this also. So most hosting services do not allow spaces in the file name. Therefore, name your web page with only alphanumeric and underscore character. Clear? So some of the times when we are saving any HTML page, so various you can say the browsers or the different internet hosting services where we host our web pages, so there the file name, with the file name the spaces are not allowed. Clear? So for to overcome this, we can use any alphanumeric, that is number and text, and we can use the underscore. Already you know what is underscore. Suppose the name is file1, so you are writing this file1, so rather than writing file space 1, you can use this underscore, which is like this, the symbol which is written below that. Clear? So this way you can give a space between, and it is not exactly a space bar, it is a underscore symbol. Clear? So this way we can overcome for those web hosting services where the spaces are not allowed. Next is the HTML software is a software that converts the text to HTML code. Clear? Any of the software which convert the normal text to HTML code, that is called as HTML converter. Next is HTML editor is a software that insert HTML code as you work to create a HTML file. Clear? So HTML editor, we have already seen that HTML editors are those editors where the different HTML codes are entered. Not only that, the different, you can say the elements like image, text, whatever the element which you want to include in the HTML document, that also can be easily inserted with the HTML editors. There we have the graphics to work with, so it will make our work easy for the designing of web pages. Clear? Let us erase this. Now coming to the next. So the earlier document which we have saved, let us see that first, then we will come to the next. So this was the text which we have written, and it was saved with .html extension. Let us now see that how it is going to appear on the desktop. So here it was saved with the name new. Here you can see a symbol with the name new. If I double click, clear? So here you can see the same text is now appearing in a web browser. Clear? This is the Firefox browser. So whatever the text which you have written there, you can see easily that the same text is appearing in the web page. We have not included any of the element, any tag, but basically when we have saved with .html, a basic few of the normal, you can say the tags like HTML, that was included with the text which we have written, that is why it is appearing in this web page. Clear? So using any of the editors, simply by saving this in the HTML format, this can be converted into a, you can say, HTML document. Clear? We will see further when we'll come to the book. Clear? Let us see now the basic use of this HTML tags. So already we have seen the name of the tags. Now let us see how to use them. So you can use a set of HTML tags to define the basic structure of your page. HTML tags controls the layout and the formatting of the element in the HTML. Clear? So what is the use of these HTML tags? This controls the layout. Clear? How it is controlling the layout? Suppose we are writing the HTML tag in the beginning and in the end. So a normal text which is written, this will be converted in the form of HTML page, and then it can appear in the web page as well. Now if you are using the head tag, title tag or body tag, so this head or body tag will give the layout of the web page. Clear? If it is title, then it will appear at the top. If it is the body content, then it will appear in the web page. Then we will see further the heading tag. It will give you the size of or heading of the web page. Clear? So this way the formatting, the layout of the web page is going to be decided by the different tags which you are using in this HTML document. Clear? And we can format the web page. Formatting here means changing the style, layout, appearance of the web page. Clear? So this HTML tag is not only controlling the layout, but as well as we can format the design of the web page also. So these tags are the building blocks of the HTML. So as it is the, you can say, the basic and fundamental things to be used in the HTML pages. So that is why they are also called as building blocks of the HTML. So some basic HTML tags which we have seen also are HTML, then head, title, body. Clear? So these are the basic and fundamental HTML tags that you must add to every web page to create as discussed below. Clear? So these are the tags which is required to be written in or to be included in any of the text which we want to be converted into the HTML page. Clear? So this was the earlier paragraph which we have written. So when we have saved that paragraph in .html extension, so basically the HTML tag were inserted in the beginning and at the end. Clear? So the same if you are writing any paragraph, if you'll include this HTML tag at the beginning and at the end, so a normal and a basic web page can be designed with this. Clear? So what is the required thing to be taken care of? That in the beginning we will write the HTML tag, and in the closing we are writing the closing HTML. The difference is this forward slash along with this. Clear? So this way the document can be declared in the HTML format. Next is the heading tag, which we have seen earlier as well. So heading tag will be written after the HTML tag, and in this heading tag we can give the information of the web page, that is the you can say the title of the web page, then other things, this all can be included in this heading tag. So this is the expressive information about the web page. Clear? For example, the title and the various other things. Clear? So this heading can be written below the HTML tag, and we have seen earlier also the example like this one. Clear? So this heading is required to be written after the HTML, and within this head tag, the heading tag, we can write the information which is about this web page, for example the title. Clear? So this all will be written within the head tag, and after writing this we will need to close the title tag as well as the heading tag. Clear? And when we have written this heading tag, after closing this we will start the body tag. Clear? Let us come to the book once again. So this was the heading tag. Next, if we come to the next, that is, let us read this update your knowledge as well. So HTML tags comes in pairs with the ending tags containing an additional forward slash. This I am telling you that when we are using the ending tag, not all the HTML tags are coming with HTML. There are two types, one is empty tag and another is container tag. So with the container tag only, we have the closing tag which is appearing with this forward slash symbol when it is the ending tag. Now the next is an element in HTML refers to a tag such as head, body, and these are the different tags. Like heading we have already seen, body for writing the main content of the page. Then next is P, this is the paragraph tag. Clear? So let us read this again. An element in HTML refers to a tag or element of the structure of a document such as body, title, and paragraph. Clear? So using these tags, we are referring to the different elements or the structure of the document, which are the body, title, and paragraph. So today we have seen about the basic tags of this, how to save any text which we are writing, and if you want to convert in HTML format, only thing we need to do is to save this with .html extension. Clear? In the coming class we will continue further and see the different other tags like title tag, body tag. Till then, read and revise this thing, and the doubts we will take up in the online session. Thank you.